In this video, we will try to shed some light on the mystery of trim speed. We are currently in level flight and trimmed for 70 knots. I took my hands off the sticker so that we can explore what the aircraft does during power changes when left to itself. First we add power. I do this slowly to prevent any larger oscillations. You can see that the aircraft accelerates just briefly and then begins to climb. Throughout the whole maneuver, the aircraft roughly maintains its trim speed of about 70 knots. So adding power doesn't cause the aircraft to speed up, as one might expect, but causes the aircraft to climb. In fact, the aircraft even flies a little slower now. Next, we reduce power to idle. Again, I'll do this slowly to prevent larger oscillations. Now you can see that the aircraft decelerates just briefly and then begins to descend. Again, throughout the whole maneuver, the aircraft roughly maintains its trim speed of about 70 knots. And now we get some oscillations that we have to wait out. So reducing power did not cause the aircraft to slow down, as one might expect, but caused the aircraft to descend. In fact, the aircraft even flies a little faster now. To understand what's going on here, it's important to know that the lift depends on angle of attack and airspeed. The larger both are, the more lift is created. Angle of attack is the angle between the orange chord line of the wing and the cyan airflow. The present angle of attack is shown here, and currently is 8.5 degrees. The angle of attack of the wing is controlled by the deflection of the elevator. This is due to the fact that the chord line of the elevator always weathervanes into the airflow. Therefore, changing the deflection of the elevator changes the angle of attack of the wing accordingly. However, for this demonstration, we have trimmed the aircraft for an airspeed of 70 knots and will not change the deflection of the elevator. Remember that I took my hands off the stick. Therefore, the elevator will maintain a constant angle of attack of 8.5 degrees throughout the whole maneuver. Now let's see what happens if we add power. If we add power, the aircraft briefly speeds up. But not for long, because speeding up causes an increase in lift. Notice that lift increased about 70 kilogram force. This additional lift causes the aircraft to change its flight path into a climb. Notice that the airflow changes and the tail of the aircraft weather vanes into the changing airflow. This causes the aircraft to pitch up. Also notice that the angle of attack on the wing remains constant because the tail always weather vanes into the airflow. This is really important, the angle of attack on the wing remains constant throughout the whole maneuver. Next, the induced climb causes the aircraft to slow down. Now it slows down even too much and too little lift is created, 50 kilograms too little. Therefore, the aircraft pitches down and speeds up again. This over and undershooting of our trim speed causes a few oscillations before the aircraft stabilizes. Now the aircraft found a new balance. The angle of attack is still 8.5 degrees and our airspeed is still 70 knots. So what happened is that the aircraft converted the additional power into a climb. If we reduce power, the opposite happens. First, the aircraft briefly slows down, but again not for long. Because slowing down causes a decrease in lift. Notice that lift decreased by about 50 kilogram force. This lack of lift causes the aircraft to change its flight path into a descent. Now the tail of the aircraft weather vanes into the changing airflow, which causes the aircraft to pitch down. Again, the angle of attack on the wing remains constant because the tail always weather vanes into the airflow. Now the induced descent causes the aircraft to speed up. Now it's sped up even too much and too much lift is created. Therefore the aircraft pitches up and slows down. Again, this over and undershooting of our trim speed causes a few oscillations before the aircraft stabilizes. Now the aircraft found a new balance and compensates for the reduced power by descending. It is important to stress that our angle of attack remained constant throughout the whole maneuver. It remained constant because we didn't change the deflection of the elevator. Remember that I took my hands off the stick. And the elevator controls the angle of attack of the wing because it always weather vanes into the airflow. Therefore, the angle of attack of the wing is equal to the difference in pitch between the wing and the elevator. Now, for each angle of attack, there is exactly one airspeed at which the wing generates the right amount of lift to carry our weight. You can see this speed in the trim speed diagram. This diagram shows all combination of angle of attack and airspeed that generate a wing load of 1g. Here is our current angle of attack of 8.5 degrees And if you go up to the trim speed curve, and from there to the left, you see that our current trim speed is 70 knots. Now, if we apply more power, then we momentarily go faster. But this creates too much lift. Notice that the wing load now is 1.1 g, and therefore the aircraft climbs, pitches up, and slows down to regain its trim speed. After a few oscillations, the aircraft will stabilize in a climb with 70 knots. And if we reduce power, then we momentarily go slower. But this creates too little lift. The wing load is now just 0.8 g, and therefore the aircraft descends, pitches down, and speeds up to regain its trim speed. After a few oscillations, the aircraft will again stabilize, now in a descent with 70 knots. Yeah, and that's why an aircraft holds its trim speed. But one last mystery still remains to be solved. Why did the aircraft slow down when we added power? And why did it speed up when we reduced power? The reason for this is that the propeller slipstream changed the airflow over the elevator. To simulate this effect, we can go to the options dialog and check the prop wash effect on elevator checkbox. The changing airflow on the elevator causes the aircraft to pitch up a bit, so we have to trim it down slightly. Half a degree on the elevator will do the trick. After a few oscillations, the aircraft stabilizes again. If you toggle the checkbox, you can notice a little longer flow line and a little more negative angle of attack on the elevator due to the propeller slipstream. Now let's pause for a second and check the effect of adding power. Here we see that adding power causes an even faster flow and an even more negative angle of attack on the elevator. Let's continue and add power. As always, the elevator weather vanes into the flow, and due to the simulated prop wash now commands a slightly higher angle of attack on the wing. Now the elevator commands an angle of attack of 9 degrees compared to the angle of attack of 8.5 degrees that we had without simulated prop wash. Because of this slightly higher angle of attack on the wing, we now need a little less airspeed of just 68 knots to generate a wing load of 1 g. And that's why adding power causes a decrease in trim speed. Next, let's pause and check the effect of reducing power. Now we see that reducing power causes the opposite from adding power. Reducing power causes a slower flow and a less negative angle of attack on the elevator. Let's continue and reduce power to idle. Again, the elevator weather vanes into the flow and therefore now commands a slightly lower angle of attack on the wing. The angle of attack on the wing is now just 8.1 degrees compared to the 8.5 degrees that we had without simulated prop wash. Now, the no power situation is exactly the same with or without simulated prop wash because there is no prop wash. However, remember that we had to trim down to maintain level flight, and due to the missing prop wash, the elevator now commands a lower angle of attack on the wing. Because of this slightly lower angle of attack on the wing, we now need a little more airspeed of 73 knots to generate a wing load of 1 g. And that's why reducing power causes an increase in trim speed. And this brings us to the end of this video. I hope that I could shed some light on the mysteries of trim speed. Please feel free to play around with the simulator if you like. The link to FOFSIM is in the description below. And as always, thanks for flying with me, and I hope to see you on board again soon.